हम देख रहे हैं ह्यूमन इवोल्यूशन के बारे में। तो अब तक हमने देखा कि प्राइमेट्स क्या थे, कहाँ एमर्ज हुए, कैसे थे। उसके बाद हमने उनके सब ग्रुप के बारे में देखे जो कि होमिनोइड्स थे, और फिर हमने होमिनोइड्स के फीचर्स देखे, कहाँ और कैसे एमर्ज हुए हुए देखे। और आगे हमने देखा कि होमिनिड्स जो कि होमिनोइड्स से इवोल्व हुआ, उनमें और होमिनोइड्स में डिफरेंसेस क्या थे, सिमिलरिटीज क्या थे। आज हम देखेंगे कि होमिनिड्स के जो ब्रांचेस थे, ब्रांचेस इंपॉर्टेंट ब्रांचेस देखेंगे, ऑस्ट्रेलोपिटेकस एंड होमो। फिर हम डिस्कस करेंगे पॉजिटिव फीडबैक मैकेनिज्म के बारे में, और आगे हम देखेंगे द थियोरीज रिलेटिंग टू द ओरिजिन ऑफ मॉडर्न ह्यूमन बींग्स। As we know that hominids have different branches, and Australopithecus and Homo are two important branches among them. Both Australopithecus and Homo includes several species. Virtually all the names given by scientists to species are derived from Latin and Greek words. For instance, the name Australopithecus comes from a Latin word austral and meaning southern, and a Greek word pithecos meaning ape. The name was given because this earliest form of human still retained many features of an ape. The important characteristics of Australopithecus are long forelimbs, curved hand and foot bones, and mobile ankles joint, which were suited to life on trees as they spent a lot of times on trees. With that, they had small brain size, large back teeth, and limited dexterity of the hands. The fossils of Australopithecus was discovered at Old Dubai Gorge in 17 July 1959 by Mary and Louis Leakey. The major differences between Australopithecus and Homo relate to brain size, jaws, and teeth. The former has a smaller brain size, heavier jaws, and larger teeth than the latter. The remains of early human have been classified into different species because of differences in their bone structures. So, some of the features or developments in the anatomy of early human beings favored or shaped them to become modern human beings. These developments are together called positive feedback mechanism. So we will see how positive feedback mechanism help us to understand how what conditions or developments helped early human beings to shape them to become modern human beings. We'll see how increase in size and capacity of brain helped them to visual surveillance, long distance walking while foraging and hunting. Then this helped them to upright walking, and upright walking helped them to hands free for using tools and carrying infants and object, and this freed hands helped them to making tools. And how tool making was possible? Tool making was possible because of the increase in size and capacity of brain. We already know that Homo is another important branch of hominids. Homo is a Latin word meaning man, although there were women. And there are several types of Homo, like Homo habilis. Homo habilis means these names were given according to their characteristics. Like Homo habilis were the tool makers. And then Homo erectus. Homo erectus were the upright man, and Homo sapiens meaning the wise or thinking man. So Homo fossils or of Homo habilis have been discovered
fossils from, of Homo habilis have been discovered at Omo in Ethiopia and at Old Dubai Gorge in Tanzania.
The earliest fossils of Homo erectus have been found
both in Africa and Asia. The oldest species of Homo sapiens are Homo heidelbergensis and Homo neanderthalensis. The fossils of Homo heidelbergensis, which existed between 0.8 to 0.1 million years ago, have been found in Africa, Asia, and Europe. The Neanderthals occupied Europe and Western and Central Asia from roughly 130,000 years to 35,000 years ago. They disappeared abruptly in Western Europe around 35,000 years ago. तो अब तक हम जान चुके हैं कि प्रीकर्सर्स ऑफ मॉडर्न ह्यूमन बींग्स कैसे थे. तो आगे हम देखेंगे कि द स्टोरी ऑफ मॉडर्न ह्यूमन बींग्स. इसमें हम देखेंगे मेनली द थ्योरीज रिलेटिंग टू द ओरिजिन ऑफ मॉडर्न ह्यूमन बींग्स. द इशू ऑफ द प्लेस ऑफ ओरिजिन ऑफ मॉडर्न ह्यूमन्स हैज बीन मच डिबेटेड बाय द स्कॉलर्स. Two totally divergent views has been expounded, one advocating the regional continuity model and the other replacement model. The regional continuity model. According to the regional continuity model, the Homo sapiens originated in different regions or continents and gradually evolved at different rates into modern humans. The theory is based on the regional differences in the features of present-day humans, such as skin color, height, hair color, etc. According to those who advocate this view, these similarities are due to differences between pre-existing Homo erectus and Homo sapiens populations that occupied the same regions. And the other, the replacement model. According to the replacement model, human beings first originated in a single region, which is Africa, and migrated to all the other regions or continents. Those who are in support of this view take the evidence of the genetic and anatomical homogeneity of modern humans, such as two hands, two legs, five fingers, two eyes, etc. The enormous similarity amongst modern humans is due to their descent from a population that originated in a single region, that is Africa.